Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to another interesting episode of Christmas calendar tutorial series. And in this one, I will show you how you can share user defaults between your apps and your targets. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay. Now, I have a previous video, basically two videos on how to share the keychain with different apps and different targets. Now it is time to take a look at how to share some data with the user defaults. Now remember, user defaults are basically simple plist files, so they can be hacked quite easily. It is not the time to save and share your, let's say, in-app purchases data with this kind of approach. You would rather use keychain, so go ahead and take a look at that video. You could, let's say, share some scores or usernames or something like that. And we will share our username today. Okay, let's just start off by creating a brand new project. And I will choose the single view application from Rebeloper. Go ahead and click the link down below to find out more how you can create your custom Xcode project template. And click on next. And the product name will be, let's say, and the root view controller will be the view controller. Basically, this project template eliminates the main.storyboard altogether. We are going to start off right off the bat without the storyboard. Okay, let's create a new folder here. Okay, and another one with the title code. Okay, and I will create a Git repository on my Mac. Great. And that's it for our Xcode setup. What we want to do first? Well, I will just show you how you can do this for sharing in the target. Let's say for this target, and I will create an extension, an iMessage app extension, and we will share between those. You could test it out with a different app. It is the same process. So let me just create a new target here, and it will be an iMessage extension, and I will name this. Okay, let's click on finish there. Okay, let's activate this, and we are ready to start off. Okay, first of all, we need to create some sort of keys where we can store our suit name, and we will get back to that later on. But for now, let us just create a new file that will help us along the way. It will be a Swift file. Let's click on next and make sure that the extension target is checked. Okay, let's click on create. There we go. We are going to simply create here a struct. Let me just make this a little bit larger so you may see. I will just use command plus. Okay, there we go. So let's create our struct, and it will be named shared user defaults. And first of all, we will need a static let and suit name, and we will add in something here just in a minute. Finally, we will create another struct, and that will be named keys. And for the keys, I want to create a static let and user name equals username. Let me just copy this out and paste it in there. Okay, and that's it for our shared user defaults. Now it's time to mess around with user defaults in the view controller. So let's say, let's create our username. Let it be Alex. Okay, now we want to save it to user defaults. And The standard way of using user defaults is userdefaults.standard, pun intended. So let's use that userdefaults.standard and set, and we will use this any for key, and the value will be username, and the key will be let's use the shared. Let me just hit Command B so auto completion will work. So shared userdefaults.keys and username. Okay, this isn't just quite yet the shared user defaults, but hey, we can live with that. Now let's get our username and print it out. Let's say saved username equals, and we will go something like this, user defaults, and I believe it's standard and string or something like that, string for key, that is it, and shared user defaults dot keys dot username, and let's print this out. Print username equals saved username. Okay, let's see how this works. Okay, and maybe we need to unwrap it. Yes, so guard, let, and else, let's return. Great, that should work okay. Now let us just select our target that we are just working on, and let's build and run and see what comes up in the log. Hopefully we will see username equals Alex. Okay, let's just wait for that, and there we go, username is Alex. Great. Now we could use this in this target because it's the standard user defaults. Now let's move on and create another user defaults, another container that will be accessible in the extension too. So for that we need to use app groups. So go ahead and select your target first, this one, shared user defaults, and go into capabilities and select on for app groups. Okay, you will be shown your own app groups, but we will create one for this tutorial, and I will go to general, copy my bundle identifier, go back to capabilities and click on the plus button. And as you can see, we have a prefix of group, so I'm just simply paste my bundle identifier, so this would be it. So let's click on OK. Let's wait for it to add the app groups feature. So once and add group to your app ID, you will see the entitlements has been created. Here we go. We have our app groups item 0. Now let's do the same for our extension. Okay, let's just select our extension target and set it to on. And now you will be able to find your extension group. So it will be something like shared user defaults tutorial. That's it, I believe. So let's wait for it to complete. Well, let's just click away and then click back again. There we go. And the check mark is there. Okay, now once that is in, we need to grab our app group user defaults. Well, that is in the shared user defaults suit name. So let's paste that in there. So group, I believe. Was that the group? Let's see. Yes, it's group.com, redeveloper, and so on. So that is our suit name. Now let's initialize user defaults. Let's go back to our view controller. And instead of this, let's just comment this out. We will create a user defaults constant, and I will add it up before the class because this will be available all over my project. So let user let's name this shared user defaults equals, and we will use user defaults, and we are not going to add a dot like standard and so on. Let's add a parenthesis and add our suite name, and that is shared user defaults dot suite name. So that is how you initialize it. And now with this shared user defaults, let's save our name. Okay, let me just comment all of this out. Okay, so shared user defaults, and let's set our value. The value is user name for the key, shared user defaults keys username. Great. And now let's unwrap it. So guard let shared username equals, and now we will use shared user defaults and string for key, and that is shared user defaults dot keys dot username user name. And finally, let's print it out. Print. So basically, this is still on the same target, but hey, we can check it out. Let's not forget our else return here. Okay, so let's build again and see if we do get this shared. Oh, sorry about that. Let me just copy our shared username here and paste it in there. Okay, let's see how it works. And there we go. Shared username is Alex. Now, what we need to do is add the same things in the extension or the other app that you want to share your user defaults with the suite name. Okay, let's go into our messages view controller and add this here. And finally, I would just simply copy this guardlet unwrapped statement and shared username print. Okay, let's go there and let's see. Now, as you can see, we are not setting our user name just yet in the extension. So let's run our extension. First of all, let's stop this and let's run our extension, and hopefully we will see shared username Alex. Okay, and there we go. Let's see in the log. There we go. Shared username Alex. Great, pretty awesome stuff. And we didn't do anything. We didn't save anything in the extension app. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and use these shared user defaults with the help of app groups in your own apps. Most precisely, share it between two separate apps, not just targets like I have just shown you. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and click that notification bell so you may get notified when new videos come out from my channel. Now, as always, I will see you in the next one.